Good morning, folks. Apologize for the delay this morning. We'll get you your news and get you on your way, starting with our star at spaceweathernews.com. And we find the last day very quiet. Coronal hole turning through on the south. Couple bright points on the Earth-facing half, but no sunspots beneath them, and certainly no eruptive action. We await the solar wind from that southern coronal hole, but the telemetry overnight was of note as well. Up top, blue, phi angle, once again flipping and maintaining a bit of stability, and that was accompanied by a plasma speed bump in purple below. That is another current sheet effect, crossing the solar wind magnetic sectors and again caused a brief geomagnetic event. A quick reminder that the galaxy has a current sheet separating its north and south fields as well, but also a ton of dust and ion content accompanying it. Now, what happens when the galaxy imparts an electromagnetic disruption to the sun in the larger scale version of what just happened on Earth? Cosmic Disaster Video explains it, and it's linked in the box below the video. We're on to earthquakes. They say that patterns abound beyond their wildest imaginations, but that the patterns seem to be similar for both large and small quakes, making it hard to know if one of the sequences they've identified is going to be worth warning about. It might be interesting to see them combine their precursory factors with ours over at quakewatch.net, considering they are generally made to pick out the big ones. It could fill in the gap. Interesting piece on the worst prediction in physics, the cosmological constant. At this channel, we have previously looked at the vacuum catastrophe, but this current problem presents one orders of magnitude more challenging, and they want to start tweaking Einstein to fix it. Good luck there. Up next, an interesting article, and I want to see if you can notice the problem before I tell it to you at the end of the article segment. So they are looking into the earthquake and tsunami that hit Palu, Indonesia last year, asking how such a quake, lower than normal tsunami-making magnitude, was able to do it. They create a model, a beautiful video to go with it. But here's the problem. As you might remember, is that the earthquake did not cause the tsunami. It was a flank collapse of the volcano that did it, and that is a very, very big oops. It was a nice video, though. Up next, there are many kinds of nova and all worth knowing about. This one is actually not a stellar explosion, but a surge in energy of the disk surrounding the young star. Essentially means this one is taking big swings at the heavens while still in diapers. Had a 40-minute call with Monty Childs of the Sapphire Project last night. You might know their key scientist, Michael Claridge, has spoken at three straight of our annual conferences, and today I'd like to share their latest video. It is linked below, and it is in support of plasma cosmology. And speaking of that electromagnetic reality, top two stories today hit Birkeland currents, even though they call them something else, and they demonstrate that these fully satisfy the equations and observations. An electric cosmos, and its catwalks are magnetic. This is a follow-up paper contributed to the 36th International Cosmic Ray Conference, and it confirms magnetism dominates the large-scale cosmic web. That makes 10 amazing papers I really wish would have come out before we made that plasma cosmology movie last month. That movie, the catastrophe movie we mentioned earlier, and the climate movie, all linked for you below this video in the description box. We greatly appreciate your support. We've got wind map forecasts and shots of our star to close. We'll do this all again tomorrow, right here, but right now it's 5:55 a.m. in the new Valley of the Sun. Eyes open, no fear. Be safe, everyone.